and you want the living will. Here's some cost on Walmart. Didn't know if you knew this, but you can buy your own casket on Walmart. So things cost and they're expensive, and you kind of deciding what you want to have and how you want to be buried or cremated or those kind of things, that's part of having a discussion with your family members. Because if you don't, they don't know what you want necessarily, and they will then buy the most expensive casket because you deserve it, right? And they don't want to put you in a pine box. My dad says, just get some pine and build a box and stick them in it, something that costs $100. But so it's a again a stressful and emotional time. So you make your plans and decisions before you die. You want to know your funeral plans. You want to you don't have to go that far if you don't want, but at least you have some ideas. You want to let people know. You have organize your important docs and where they are. Let someone know who gets what with a will, your medical treatment, your living will, how to pay for your funeral and life expenses, your life insurance, right? In other words, be loving to your heirs and family. Have a plan. And part of that then can be in your letter of last instruction, which isn't legally binding, but it gives information, right? It could talk about your funeral preferences, talk about communicating to people upon your death that you want them to know, location and information about bank accounts and safe deposit boxes and real estate owned and assets, et cetera. And then again, obviously, a will, et cetera, that will dispose of your different effects. Yeah, there's lots of expenses for funeral, right? The reception, we're going to hold it. I mean, lots of different things. And so even if you're a single person and have debt, and gonna have if you die and have funeral expenses, you should have some life insurance on yourself so that it's not a burden to your family, that they can take care of your wishes and do a good funeral for you according to your wishes and pay off your debts, et cetera. And that's if you're single, not married, no children, because it's still an expense. So what about then there's digital assets as well as keeping your records. And so a lot of information is stored electronically. It provides access to financial assets, needs usernames and passwords or PINs. And so some resources down here and on our resource page, University of Idaho has a good one that goes through and you put down, names of insurances that you have and your financial and your doctors that you use and all these different things, digital assets. And so you can get on there and my wife and I use this and you can input it. And so she's aware, it's good communication for spouses as well. We're family members. She knows everything we have. I know everything we have. We know what insurance is with for the cars or the home, if we have different things or for investment properties. Everything's there. And it's locked up. I mean, you have to make sure that it's password protected, et cetera, so someone doesn't get hold of that. But you want to have those types of things. Anybody have any thoughts about organizing their important documents, either digitally or in a kind of a folder that's in a lockbox or something like that? That's key. If you die and no one knows where your stuff is or what you have, that's going to be a nightmare for people to try to figure out, right? Especially if you don't have a power of attorney. All right. So key takeaways. Estate planning is not just for the wealthy, right? Even simple estates need plans. There is no magic number. Now, if your estate is under, say, $50,000, then it usually can avoid probate and not go through the system. But you still need a will to be able to tell people what you want to have happen, et cetera. Incapacity can strike at any time. However old you are, it could be a teenager, it could be 60, it could be 40, doesn't matter. Failing to plan means court will appoint a guardian and distribute your possessions as they deem fit rather than as you want. Having a health care power of attorney and a durable power of attorney designate an agent to act on your behalf. Those are key. Wills must be properly signed and witnessed. Again, you can't have a holographic will in New Mexico, so you need to either hire an attorney, which is going to probably be between $300 to $500 for a will, or you can do what I'm going to suggest that you do that's as cheap as $29, and get a will based on the state laws through a couple of these online programs so that you can have that. And then you need to go to someone that, what's it called when you go to the bank and they stamp it? They're, what am I trying to think of? So notarized, thank you. You go to a notary and you also need two witnesses. And so you take two witnesses that aren't beneficiaries or related to you, and you sign, they sign, and it's notarized. And then that's what you need. So based on your state law, your wishes notarized with at least two witnesses. Review your power of attorney designees and discuss your wishes with them. Never surprise people with key roles, right? If you want somebody to take care of your minor children, that might be something you want to talk to them about and ask them if they're willing to do and what that would entail, right? I've had people ask my wife and I, not because of me, but because of my wife, but that if we would take care of their children if they died. And my rule is if you trust me enough to take care of your children, that and you don't want that, then you care about them enough to want good things for them, that they have to have life insurance policy, and then that we have to be the ones that gets that on the behalf of the good, of the children. They can put in their will how they want it spent, but I need access. I don't want to have to be going and working with some other person that doesn't think that this kid needs braces or whatever. If you trust me with your kids, then you need to trust me with your money. And if you're not willing to do that, then you need to find somebody else. That's just me. So person that I have that to take care of our children, I have the same thing, that if my wife and I both died, then they would get all the assets of my life insurance as well as the children. So don't surprise people. And if people ask you, ask questions. I mean, think about it. There's a lot of things. Even if it's not raising children, you're the executor of the will. There's lots of things that you have to do to execute that will, and you should be compensated for that. And so somebody in there said that their sister's the executor, and they get a little bit more money. Well, they should, because it takes a lot of time and effort to do that. Couple other key takeaways: communicate before you die, right, with loved ones. Prepare a letter of last instruction and digital asset inventory so that people know where to find things, and instead of spending months and months as an investigator trying to track everything down. Think carefully about choosing an executor. Take necessary or yourself, like I said, performing executor duties. Try to avoid probate if possible. Again, a trust is best, really, but that usually costs more like $1,400, $1,500, up to $2,500, where a will is you can get that does most of what you need. If you have a will, a power of attorney, and a living will, and those are key. That's only $39, so everybody can do that. Think about family dynamics. If you have special needs, if there's blended families, what that means. And again, that gets really messy if you die without a will, and it goes to the courts, because people that you wanted to have, whether it's with your original children or stepchildren or kid to have with special needs more, that doesn't happen in the court system. So have a storage plan with your documents, and do not die without a will. So remember, this is just trying to put it in your brain, right? Nail in your brain. Everyone needs a will. Everyone needs life insurance. You need to communicate about your estate. You need to have a living will. Organize your estate and share where you're important, and help others experience savoring, flow, and service. No one will force you to plan your estate. If you wish, you can do nothing. However, by not pleading an estate plan, at least a will, you allow others to make the decisions for you rather than you being in charge.